Do you think that God has a real estate agency? God promises to give this those people or that people. This is a myth.
With the Palestinian freedom fighter Leila Khaled, who is here in Manila, Philippines, and we are to talk about her visit to the country. Her first. Good morning. Good morning, Leila.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm fine.
When did you arrive in the Philippines?
On the 9th of this month.
And how are you finding this country so far?
You know, when I come to any country, I first get acquainted with the people, mm-hmm. and with the hosts who invited me here. I'm thankful to them, to Gabriella, who invited me here and gave me the opportunity to meet the people, and also for the ILPS to attend this conference. It's an opportunity for me to know more about Philippines, about the situation here. I found that there are many similar things in common between us as Palestinians and the Philippine people, because we are facing the same enemies. So our struggle is common. And it was a good opportunity to strengthen our relations so that we can continue this struggle, not everyone alone, but also coordinating this struggle. As long as the imperialists globalize their system, we globalize also our struggle. Mm-hmm.
You mentioned attending the 5th General Assembly of the International League of People's Struggle, mm-hmm. which was your first. Mm-hmm. What can you say about the assembly?
It's very, it's an important assembly that people coming from, representatives of people from different countries, 37 countries coming to together to coordinate their activities, to exchange experiences. And we got to know more about other people in other continents. Because one cannot know everything. But in these conferences, we discuss issues that is important for everybody, and also to get knowledge, more detailed knowledge about other people in different parts of the world. For me, I knew more about the Lumads, whom I didn't know as such. I knew that the indigenous people are deprived from their rights, but I didn't know that there is a genocide war against them, just killing them under different reasons. But in general, I understood, and I met the people here in Manila who came from Mindanao because they resemble the same, they are similar in the situation that the Palestinians are, because also Israel launches wars of genocide against the Palestinian people. So we have things in common to struggle for. It's because we face the same enemies. We face Israeli occupation, we face Zionism as a part of imperialist powers, and also all of us face imperialist powers and the puppets. And here, the government is a puppet for the U.S. imperialism. So we have common things to struggle for.
The Philippine-Palestine Friendship Association has been formed, mm-hmm. and formally launched and announced during this visit. What mm-hmm. can you say about this development?
this is a step forward for the relations between our two peoples, and this will this association can make a lot for both of you know, the Filipinos and the Palestinians, because we can make activities supporting the struggles of the Filipino here in our country, and here for Palestinians also people can do things for Palestinians to support their struggle. So this association we depend on, and they, as I knew that they will form a committee for BDS, which is boycott, divest, sanctions against Israel, and this campaign influences Israel negatively, and it's a peaceful means, because also the world had an experience to isolate the apartheid regime in South Africa at the time of apartheid, so they can repeat it, but now in a more active way, because the governments at that time in the 90s, 80s and 90s, they isolated that apartheid regime and helped the people of South Africa in their struggle to end apartheid regime in South Africa. But now we have a state called Israel that have relations with many countries, and when that campaign for the apartheid regime in South Africa, only two countries did not isolate or did not boycott the regime. They were the United States and Israel. And of course, these two don't allow any others to do the same thing what happened in South Africa. But yet we are witnessing that this BA campaign is widening, it's spreading in this, in Americas, in Europe, in different parts of the world. So we are expecting that this association can do the same and getting benefit of the experience of others in BDS.
It has been a very busy first visit for you. In fact, you already addressed a very big rally the other day. Mm-hmm. What can you say about the anti-APEC protests which you participated in?
I was surprised for the organization of the protest. All sectors of the society are participating. Students, peasants, workers, Lumad, women, youth, all sectors. And beyond that, the response of the government, the police were cutting the roads everywhere. It's the same as it is in Palestine. The military, the Israeli military, they have checkpoints. Here there were walls of police in the streets because they know very well the influence of people and the strength of people when they march to the streets to say their attitude in a peaceful means, and I think it was great.
You complained about not being allowed to be at the front of the...
Yeah.
What can you say?
You know, they told me that they are spreading water. I said, it's okay, water. But in Palestine, it's bullets to kill, and this will not kill us. But they said, no, we don't like you to be hurt or something like that. But anyhow, just being there, it means that we are all in the struggle against any summits that discusses their issues and not the people's issues.
What do you know about the National Democratic Revolution in the Philippines?
Look, we had information because now it's very easy to get the information. You can Google, you can see, you can read, you can. But before, many from the beginning of our revolution in the 60s, we were educated with the struggles of other people, because we believe that we are part of the international movement for liberation or for freedom or against oppression or intervention of any countries by the imperialists. So we knew about it because it was on the news also, even before having the internet and so on. We had relations through students, Palestinian students who were here studying in Filipino universities. So relation was there, but not as, it wasn't strengthened and continuous. Now we have to renew this relation with the big movement of Bayan, with Gabriella as a women's party, and with all progressive parties in the country, because this is our duty and our right at the same time. So we can exchange the experience, and at the same time we can support each other, we extend solidarity to each other, and this will make our people, our two peoples, continue the struggle, because they are supported by each other. And it's not only the two peoples, but also there are other peoples of the world who support the Filipino struggle and the Palestinian struggle as well. So this is important to strengthen such relations. We promise that delegations from Philippines come to Palestine, and they were coming before to Palestine, supported the hospitals and schools, and now we are going to renew that they come to visit us to see, and also we to send delegations to visit Philippine and to see the people in there, for example the Lumads or other sectors of the society. So we will have a good knowledge about each other.
Aside from the fact that basically both movements have been launched in the 1960s, mm-hmm. and it's been more than nearly 50 years already, mm-hmm. since both were launched, how hopeful are you about achieving victory eventually?
Well, I'm a pessimistic person, and at the same time I have a deep belief in our people and in progressive forces in the world who support us and support our struggle. At the same time, I have a belief that the imperialist powers will not continue to exist, because the people is strength, unity is much more powerful.
You mentioned about the creation of the State of Israel after the Second World War. What can you say about the pivotal role of the Philippine government in the UN vote to allow the establishment of the State of Israel?
That was in a situation, the circumstances, the Zionists got the benefit out of the Second World War, and the Nazis were defeated, because Israel as a project is a colonial one. So the colonialists supported the Zionists, especially the British, who were they have the mandate over Palestine from this First World War, and the foreign minister of Britain at that time, Balfour, he initiated a declaration that to create a homeland for the Jews, and that was before the Second World War, 1917. So they worked hard for it, and it happened that the Second World War broke out in the 40s, and when it ended with the defeat of the Germans, I mean the Nazis at that time, the Zionists got benefit, and they said it's because of the Holocaust that beheld them. And they migrated to, with the help of the British, to Palestine, but they were planning to take the land by force. So they launched war against us. And then we were expelled. The majority of the Palestinians were expelled from the country. They brought other people from different parts of the world, just saying that this is the Jewish promised land, yani from God to them, to have a homeland, while we didn't make the Holocaust for the Jews. And it's in Europe, it's not in on the contrary, we received them with water and bread when they came, because we are human beings also. But it seemed that we were ignorant about the conspiracy that beheld us afterwards. And up till now, we are out of our country, and we are struggling for a homeland, our homeland, to go back there. They reject it. All the time, Israel ignores and doesn't accept the idea that we have the right to return to our homeland. So we will continue the struggle, and we will reach one day, if not my generation, it would be for my children, my grandchildren. It's okay. Now, the uprising now is for the young people who went to the streets to protest the Israeli policy, although they are shot dead, many of them, but yet they are still going on. In this struggle, it's different from some means, but still there is the combat there all the day. And the Israelis are hysterical about it now.
The hysterical reaction of the Zionists, the Israeli government. They are accusing the Palestinian freedom fighters, specifically the PFLP, of human rights violations, of instigating the state of unpeace in your land. Who is committing human rights violations?
Look, occupation by itself is violation of human rights, and it is terrorism. So whatever the Israelis say about us, but they are the source of terror. They are traumatizing our people. They are violating all kinds, all the international law, Geneva conventions, the fourth Geneva conventions. They violated it. Even Israel did not abide by the international ICJ in Lahai, that the building the apartheid wall is illegal. The settlements are illegal. Yet Israel is still going on with its policy. And up till now, Israel hasn't been punished even by the chapter 7 of the United Nations. Under that chapter, up till now, Israel is considers itself above international law. We as Palestinians, I represent PFLP, and also I represent all Palestinians because I'm a member of the PNC. Our revolution or our struggle is a human one. We are defending our humanity. We want to be on our land too, and we have the right for return, we have the right for self-determination as any other people in the world. Still, this occupation is the longest one. And whatever Israel pretends that we are the ones who are initiating violence, or occupation is violence, but by itself. And the fundamental equation or formula Where there is occupation, there is resistance. And this is, and resistance is guaranteed by international law also, because people have the right to resist their occupants who oppress them. So we don't consider what they say that is applicable to us. It's for them, for the Israelis.
Being a predominantly Catholic country, majority of Filipinos believe in what the Bible say, that that part of the world is promised land for the Israeli people. Can you tell us whose land is it really?
Do you think that God has a real estate agency? God promises to give this those people or that people. This is a myth. They just want to change the nature of the project itself. It's not based on religion. It's based on politics, and is based on the colonial forces in this world to plant an advanced base to protect their interests in the region. So Israel is fits there. And they describe it as something said in the Bible or in the Quran or in the Torah. I don't believe that God is not the one that they are speaking about.
What benefit would it bring the Filipino people if Palestine is freed and the Palestinian people go back to your land?
It means that we are building a democratic state where everybody can live there in peace based on duties and rights, equal duties and equal rights for all citizens, irrespective of religion, color, whatever it is. So a democratic state can build bridges of peace and cooperation with other peoples of the world. I suppose by that time also in Philippines there will be a democratic state also based on equal rights for everybody and equal duties, building socialism, because I believe that socialism is a human system.
Addressing the Filipino people, why should the Filipino people support the Palestinian struggle?
Because we are similar. We are facing the same enemy, as I said. We are facing the imperialists. We are facing Zionists. We are facing reaction also. So it means that they are in that trench, we are in this trench. So whoever is oppressed should extend solidarity to each other so that we can face those powers with a unity of peoples who can be victorious.
To summarize this interview, what's your general statement about this trip of yours?
I have to send a message to the people. First of all, it's my great pleasure that I came here. Second, this country and this homeland of the Filipino people and the indigenous people as well deserves the struggle to make it free from the bases, the American bases here, and from all kinds of intervention, all kinds of repression. The people have the right to liberate their land and to have access to the wealth of the country, not to be gone to a small gang from the society, whether it is a government or whatever it is. And the people should enjoy the wealth of their country. So my message is a solidarity message to the people. If you continue your struggle, you will be free. Freedom deserves that we pay the price for it. It's also a high price, But if we don't struggle, we will pay much multiple price for being oppressed. So we can help each other to reach to freedom. Second, this visit showed me that gave me myself as a person more strength to continue, because we are not alone in the struggle. We are having other people supporting us, extending their solidarity to us.
What will you tell the Palestinian people about the Philippines? Specifically, the Philippines?
I will tell them many things, but the main message that I will deliver to our people, that yani, across the oceans and the continent, you have other people supporting you. Don't be afraid. Continue the struggle.
Thank you.